Realize I'm muted. I just realized I am muted, so. Oops. Hey, whoever's in here, you're all more than welcome to talk. Nope, I rolled the wrong way. Hey, Amish! I'm fighting a giant yeti. I can light on fire. Ow. Nope. I hate that attack. Also, it works better if you don't miss with the bomb. Yep. Ow! And I know you're probably gonna ask how much. No, there is no way to heal. If I get hit, I get hit. There's no way to heal in combat. You have to find with little green pots, and there's none in the boss fights. Okay. Hey, can I not get stuck on the Yeti? Oh yeah, I was gonna get hit by that. I rolled into it. Okay, hi! Yeah. I have not fought Betty in a while, and I was bad at fighting Betty originally anyways. Like, it's so easy for me to get stuck on her. Often how I position myself for some reason, I get stuck. Oh, I didn't see her do that. I missed. Let me roll. Yeah, I was gonna die there. I was stuck. I still don't have. Do I not have? Do I not have sound? Or does the game not have sound? Okay, so I'm good. Okay. Well, my thing's maxed out, so... Did something get turned down here? I think something did. Yep. The game got turned down, so... There, y'all hear the game now? Okay, then.
go really cool snowball on my face.
Hit by the next one. She does it 3 times in a row. But if she catches you, that's half your health gone instantly. A bird with an umbrella. That's all people need to know for that. I don't know what this run means. I am literally a bird with an umbrella. Come on. Stop, Connor.
It's always hard to judge her. I thought she had a quarter for health. No. Advantage of upgrading your magic on this run? Because it doesn't knock you out of the achievement. It just as your only melee weapon. So you can still use magic. Choose my least favorite boss. Maybe just do that roll. I feel like the roll needs to give you a little bit more time to get out of the way. To maybe get enough away from her. But nah, I think she's... Like a lot of the bosses in this game, there are a lot of really, really good bosses. I need to go over here and upgrade. I'm about to have basically a boss right now. I have one more boss I want to do on the stream, which is the next boss, which is going to be Great Crow. I don't know what this dude. Ooh, damage, or I want to upgrade. Charge faster, just damage. The last bosses I have left, I use a lot of magic on, so... I use a lot of magic on the boss farm, especially the boss farm left, which is Great Crow's next boss. I have a lot of magic I use. Actually, I'm just basically spamming the hookshot attack. Required to talk to him is the key payment for this one. You can talk to him for if you don't know where to go. There's no life to be seen. Hello? Death! Are you Death? I thought the Tales of the Original Reaper were just the mad ramblings of the Freakers. Yeah, well, I guess that's me. So, if you didn't know I was real, then that means you're not here to rescue me. I know. Sorry, we're here for another purpose. In fact, you might be able to help us. Wow, rude. You're alright, I mean, what's a few more minutes after 7th century? So why are you here, actually? How did you even get here? You see, souls had to pass through Death's, your door. We are service boundary. We require the souls to finish our task and restore our statue of permission. Otherwise, we will die. Ah! Awkward. If you look for a soul here, then you're out of luck. I need non-corporeal souls that pass through the door and absorb into the aether. Soul energy has to be recycled to create new life. That's why my job was so important, not that the living didn't hate me for it. I I used to go around between souls myself to pick one and take it beyond the veil. But it was so depressing. Not for the souls, they don't care, but for the living ones they left behind. I wish I could let them know dying isn't scary. It's just a cycle of life. Thing is, if the vast of time I got very tired of that cycle. Then one day, a strange being gave me the prophecy. Oh, so that's what the one that's like. This being could create portals, doors, places. They offered to outsource the collection of souls to an automated system using one of their doors. While it was open, it would draw in the souls to a lighthouse on the shores of the ether. In return for this, they asked for their lives to be extended. Well, actually, they asked for immortality, but that's impossible. If souls stick around too long past their expiry date, then with nothing left to tie them to immortality, they decay into demonic forms, which is the bosses we have fought. All life must end. Well, eventually. So while I kick back, several generations of these self-proclaimed Lord of Doors came and went, enjoying their unnaturally long lives, each one agreeing, in the end, to submit to the limitations of life and go willingly into the ether. Until one didn't. Which brings us to your current Lord of Doors. Towards the end of what should have been their lifespan, the Lord betrayed a long-standing agreement. They said there was some kind of incident, that the door had malfunctioned and needed to be remade anew. For the door to be reconstructed, it required the touch of death to link the door to the Aether. But after this new door was created and opened, the Lord kicked me inside and sealed it shut. No way for me to escape. No way for stray souls to pass on to the Aether. No death among the living. I've been here, alone, ever since. But my assigned soul, it must be here. It has to be here. I tracked it through this door. It must have entered here somehow. Are you sure you haven't seen it? Sorry, guy. If a soul comes in here without a body, it disappears into the Aether. Sooner or later, everything that begins has to end. So, there's no hope. It must be here still somewhere. No, 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 no! I wasted so many years searching for that soul. Decades, centuries. I refuse to die. Uh-oh. I sent you a little past your best before date. The great... That's just, I love that, that's just fantastic. Damage that isn't a DOT, which is where also I'm going to be using the fire shot out of a lot. So, see though, I hit him once the fire does not catch him. Really good tail for when you have to start charging.
doesn't have a good time. And that's what I really, really hate about him.
He doesn't have a good time.
And by his own, I'm not talking about physical tail. When I'm talking about a tail in boss fights and stuff, it's something that's telling you that they're about to do something. So like him, a tail for when he's about to start charging. Like Betty's tail for her about to do her roll is the jump she did right before it. Frog King's tail is about to do the suck test when he's on the bottom right of the platform. Top left was...
You ever have to be aware of the shot?
Yay!
I have to go back and get my butt kicked. I like this boss, though. This is actually probably one of my favorite fights. See, I kind of like how...
I don't know.
to be very, very, very aggressive using the daggers or something. Of course, I think I'm doing Umbrella Run. But you are going to have so many bird heads. It's not even going to be funny. Hookshot stuff, it's a very good time to get rid of the bird heads. Or you can work on corralling them up to when he lands, you can nail him with all of them. Is the final boss. I'm actually going to be, instead of doing it all in one stream, I'm actually going to be separating them. Because the final boss is a very, very long boss, and if you leave, you have to go all the way back. He just ate a lot of this. Charged. Thank you. That charge is very, very good at getting me. Of course, the way you can get around, of course, is being behind him or to his back or to his side. That doesn't charge right into you. But yeah, I'm very bad at that. If you're wondering how low his health was, I would say probably 25%, 25, 45, somewhere around there. You can't judge really that well. I'm pretty sure he's close to getting his phase 2 moveset though, which I think around is around. Around half health there. I was saying somewhere around half health.
Yes,
These bosses have a lot of health. Even without Umbrella, they still have a lot of health. He does do damage and will cause the birdhead to spawn. So yeah, it looks like watching a little bit of a replay there. I did the backslash. Okay, I might have spawned way too many here. This is probably what's wrong with tonight. That'd have been a lot of damage. I mean.
Thank you.
Dang it!
He was probably a quarter of health left, I would say there. Quarter. Maybe a little bit less.
He wasn't... See, I don't remember how bright pink he glows, though. That's the thing. I don't remember how bright they glow. That one glows.
Thank you.
so close to death there.
Dodge the wrong way on that chain attack. Okay, that's every good fight you want to have. There, but it seems like about half health he does it. Bye, Great Crow.
time to go to sleep. All that's left is the final boss. Then we're done. Might do Gravekeeper, might do a secret boss also, but not sure. I can't tell you how long it's been since I felt a fresh breeze on my face or saw well. In it then. You never appreciate something until it's gone, do you? I saw that a lot of that in my job. Until your Lord of Doors locked me up, I never thought it would apply to me. I'm sorry about your big feather friend back there. It's always hard for the living to let go of the dead. Even more of a rough one, having to reap him yourself. I can understand that feeling. Even if it wasn't your intention, you done me a huge favor here, Crow. But this isn't over quite yet. Because while the door has been destroyed, my power is unfortunately still trapped in its remain. Forging the door requires a piece of my own soul. I need it back before I can do my job again. That means if we want to end this cycle, someone else has to take down the Lord of Doors. Have you guessed who yet? I won't be making any more deals again, that's for sure. Head back to your office and reap your boss's soul. And remember, death is on your side. Also, say hello to Death Amish. All that's left is the final boss. The final boss is long, so I'm actually going to have to save it for a second stream. And I really don't want to go do the bow guy either. All I have left for bosses is the guy that guards the bow upgrade. One of the bosses for the final, after final, which I also don't have access to yet, so that would be final boss. And, okay, I have the person that guards the bow upgrade. I have final boss, boss after the secret, and then average chest left. I'm not going to do the average chest because they're already, that one is a nightmare, so I'm not going to do it. I might do the other boss after the final. I'm losing this one. I like doing the death voice, so that's it. If you want to see what these people are saying, I do have I don't have a playlist yet. Keeping to make the playlist for the first playthrough. But if y'all want to, y'all can watch that. It is literally me going through the entire game. Including the trilogy. I want to. And 600 is not enough to upgrade anything. Okay, well, I'm in this here. If y'all have enjoyed, if y'all watching this on Twitch, give it a follow. Give the Twitch channel a follow. If y'all watching this on YouTube after I've uploaded it, give it a subscribe and miss any of the other videos. I can't raid you. Obviously, you can go live and I can raid you. And I hope to see you next time. Goodbye.